Today's a big day. Going to Hilo.
We killed it with our trial order from Vegas. Now Chef Barry wants more. This time around, 1,800 pounds of fish. We're headed to one of the hottest spots in Hawaii to try to fill it.
Watch your thingies.
Ooh. Keep going.
The old man's got a lot of marks over there. Well, a few marks anyways.
Never really been able to do this before because, we had a little boat.
19 feet of fury just wasn't enough.
Hilo's the largest city on the Big Island, and it's got one of the oldest fish markets. It's been around since 1899, but it's on the windward side of the island. So even though the fishing over there is legendary, so are the big seas.
That right there is exactly why we bought this boat.
So we can do this kind of stuff. We can go over into weather like this, get to where the fish are.
Looks pretty secured.
With our luck, what could possibly go wrong?
So the new boat's ready. Jeff's on his way to pick me up. I'm just getting used to this. I mean, it is hot here. It looks beautiful, but I guess palm trees grow in hell.
My man.
I'm going with you.
You ready?
Going with you, yep.
All right, my man, let's go.
I put $100,000 down to buy this boat with Josh and Casey. So you can bet your ass I want to see some action. I want to see $100,000 worth of action. Ready to roll. And they come over here for my health.
It's a big day, man. Hilo or bust.
When in doubt, we'll check it out.
I haven't been to Hilo for 20-something years.
Yeah.
I remember it was like twice as good.
On the chart, did it say that your dad went to Hilo?
Oh, yeah. He definitely went there.
The only problem with heading over to Hilo is we have to tow a 16,000-pound boat and trailer over Mauna Kea, which is the biggest mountain in the state, without blowing the motor or the tranny.
Going over 13,000 some odd feet, it's actually the largest mountain in the world if you measure from the seafloor.
That's a lot of weight behind your truck.
Probably sitting on like max capacity for that trailer.
Yeah, we're not even in the vicinity of low oxygen yet. We're just like getting our feet on the ground right now. We're gonna go real fast. You'll start feeling it in your ears. You'll start feeling the pressure in your head. So it's a climb, man. The altitude will get to you.
You gotta use your brakes a lot on the way back down. I don't know if he realizes that.
No.
Temperature gauges are getting up there.
So you think we're even gonna make it?
I don't know, man.
I'm watching his truck. I'm making sure he doesn't have any smoke coming out. I'm concerned about his truck overheating.
He's going slower and slower, my friend.
Yep, that's good though. Last thing we want to do is blow his engine or blow a tire or something happen and we're in the middle of nowhere.
So the fisher over there is going to pay off twice as good, right?
Yeah, my cousin gave me a heads up that, you know, the other side of the island's biting right now. But I'm not going to say that I'm not nervous.
Yeah, I can tell.
I'm stoked that we're making the trip over to Hilo. And the fishing's supposed to be red hot over there right now. You'll start feeling the pressure. We're going up high.
With that said, I'll feel a lot better once we get over Mauna Kea and headed down to the other side.
Look, you think he's going to make it?
Casey's doing good. He's doing a good speed. A lot of people worry about pulling their boat, and it's kind of an understatement. Like, I'm more scared about stopping my boat than I am pulling it, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Getting up's only half the battle. You got to go all the way back down. And going down, it's just as steep, man. Oh, yeah. Hey, overheating is going to affect the engine. Not being able to stop, I mean, dude, that could kill everybody.
I'm at about 4,000 foot right now. All right, man, right up here's the top. I think we're gonna make it. That's it, here's the top. It's all downhill from there.
I still have the brakes hold. Going downhill is a totally different battle.
We should be talking to him on the walkie.
Radio check, you got us there?
Yeah, I got you 5x5.
How's it look there?
You're looking good, man, going straight down the road. Just lost a tooth.
What the You just pulled that off now? Serious?
It sounded like you said you just lost a tooth.
Yeah, so I'm gonna have to stop and get some glue, dude. I gotta put my tooth back in my head.
Yeah,
joking,
are you?
Are you?
I gotta stop for a damn tooth. It'll stop! Yeah. It'll go right back in.
I just need some glue.
Oh my God. Josh should be throwing up all over right now.
Oh, he would if he saw that?
Let me tell you, there's something going on with Barents Sea crabbers and teeth.
We're doing an extraction.
Just give it a yank. Lightweight.
Johnny is just like my dad. Nothing will stop this guy from fishing.
You ain't a man until you pull a tooth out with a pair of pliers.
Doctor, just put it back in and glue it back in.
This is a Barents Sea fix, but we're right in the middle of the town with a dentist.
Dude, I just went on a fishing trip.
It doesn't bother me at all. I'll fix it up. Let me see here.
Do not get in mouth, store away from children and animals.
Well, this goes
pretty much kind of both.
Just a little drop. Yep, good to go.
Stick it in.
Make sure you only
stick
put
it in.
Press it. Make sure you put it in one way.
Stick your tongue over that way. Oh, too much. Back her out. Back her out.
Ah. Uh-huh.
Okay. Bite down just a little bit. Hang on, let me get something to stick in there.
That's just impressive.
Here.
Oh, yeah.
Stick that and then just bite on the cookie. There you go. Just hold it down.
Okay.
That.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Doc.
You're welcome.
I'm going to throw you.
$280 sounds like.
Go fishing.
I just like a tooth back in Johnny's head.
In my professional dental opinion, Johnny needs to lay off the pineapple candy.
We're all ready?
Cool.
Hilo or bust, baby. Hilo to Vegas. Hilo to Vegas.
Can you grab that stern line?
Got here this morning, made it up over the pass between the two mountains. And so we got a lot going on today with these guys.
It's going. My cousin Kainoa. This is Vance.
Good morning, man.
All right. Hilo boys.
Nice to meet you too, man.
Casey, Johnathan.
You're not allowed to just go to Hilo and fish. I've heard a lot of stories of guys getting their tires slashed, boats lit on fire. You got to have a lot of local support. Jeff has family over in Hilo, so we kind of have an in.
Light's been early, so you know I think we'll have Vance jump on with you guys. Case, cool. Josh, show you out of the harbor. A little bit tricky. And John, you jump on me and Kainoa. We'll go out and see what we can
low
do.
Low bridge, that's all we have to deal
low,
with.
Low, low, low. Bridge. Low bridge.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. See you out there, bro.
See you too.
All right. Be
good. Hilo's by Lua Bridge was raised in 1993. It's only got 10 feet of clearance at low tide, and at high tide, it's only got 7.
All right, boys, we're going in.
Over the last 30 years, the boats have gotten a lot bigger, but the bridge is still the same. Josh and Casey are gonna be cutting it close.
All right. There's a will, there's a way.
Yep.
I'm gonna send you some money for some railing. You can't even piss on this boat or you'll fall over. Think they're gonna make it.
We're gonna see.
See, we're barely making this bridge. They're taller than we are.
The new boat is just under 10 feet tall with the tower folded down. That's only gonna leave us inches to get under the concrete bridge.
How's it look, guys?
Dude, it's gonna be a tight one, my man.
I've seen a lot of outriggers break on this bridge.
Definitely gonna be close. It's not gonna fly, dude.
How much room we got, Josh? We good?
Yeah, I think so.
Think so, or we're good to go?
I think we're good.
Oh my God.
Oh. Yeah, we're good.
We're good to go.
That was close as it gets.